topics that we have. And most exam questions are based on this chapter. So there will be graphs and all that that I'm doing. And like I said, that I'll give you my hand. Oh, yeah. Now that I've gone. These are my, they have it, they have the copies, they've scanned it, you know, the whole thing. So what is managerial economic, just in points, you know, you don't have to it's just more than enough for you to study. The demand, so you know, you see the graph, there's an example, a small explanation, exam also you have to write it in this way. They will send it to you. They have, I didn't tell them to send it first because I wanted to show you in the afternoon break. You can just see it. It's explained just to the point, and that's more than enough for your examination. Okay. Our next topic, like I just said to the ones who were there, demand and supply are the topics where most of the exam questions are asked. These are there are a lot of stuff that can be asked in the exam. Maybe like a direct question. Sometimes the question is not direct, but there will be a something from a demand or a supply. Okay, so we have to understand what is demand and what is supply from the customer's point of view, supply from the producer's point of view. Yeah. The first thing is demand. We'll be doing all demand and then we'll be doing all. What is demand?
Excuse me. The mic, please.
He's fixing that. Oh. It's again getting fixed. Demand. Who makes the demand? Buyers. Customers? Consumers? Buyers? Whatever you call it. So everything in this chapter we see, we are seeing it from the eyes of a customer. Every decision you take, every answer you give me for any of my question, you have to answer it from the point of view of a customer. Okay? Okay. So demand is done by the customer or consumer or buyer. Demand is represented by DD in economics, supply is SS. Okay? So demand, then the law. And the law says when the price, P is the price, goes up, the demand goes down. This is the normal behavior. Yeah? And when the price goes down, the demand goes down. This is a normal tendency as a customer or a consumer. When the price is up, we will buy less. When the price goes down, we tend to buy more. This is what the law says. It's a law given to us. Kanun is kanun. We cannot change it. It's not in our hand. Okay? So now, before going to the in-depth of all this, first thing when
We'll come to that.
Everything will be covered. This is the law. Like I said, it is the law. We cannot change it. Before we go into that, first thing when we talk about demand, as a term demand, Tala, it is desire. You should have the desire. If I don't have a desire for the pen, will I go and buy it? Plus, willingness. Desire is what?
Wants and needs.
I want. Willingness?
Intention.
Intention. Along with purchasing power. Ability to buy. If all these three conditions are not there, you cannot make demand complete. So a rich man has a desire to buy a car and the purchasing power But he doesn't want to buy now. He wants to buy after 6 months. Is it demand?
No.
A poor man has a desire. Musking has the willingness, but he doesn't have the ability. Is it demand?
No.
So these three conditions should be fulfilled to make demand complete. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So if they ask you, what is the meaning of demand? It is these three conditions. And if they ask you, what is the law of demand? The law which we cannot change, it is price up, demand down, price down, demand down. Okay? For now? Okay. Now, like he just raised a point and said that there are people who want to purchase expensive things. So the law becomes wrong, right? Because we have a group of people,
yes.
Some are show off.
Yes, we have the check-up scheme coming in. No one is speaking.
Who's talking? Somebody spoke?
The mic.
Outside.
The mic.
From outside it came?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, I thought somebody was telling something.
He's saying the speakers is not working on the.
Okay. But you can hear me at the last over there? Excuse me. Yeah? I can't help it. They don't have. I don't know what's wrong with their mic. So this is the law of demand. Now the thing is that we have different people. We have the rich people. We have the showing off people. Yeah. We have another category, especially, sorry, woman, I'm also one of you. We have this idea, if price is up, the quality is good. Yeah. So we have these different types of situations where the law becomes wrong. But we cannot say the law is wrong, right? So we make an assumption. Here is when we said economic is all about if there are about assumptions, this is where we apply. So when we are writing the law of demand.
Somebody need to talk with you.
There's somebody talking outside.
I will go to talk to
them.
Okay. When we talk about the law of demand, we say, other things equal, this is an iftira, assumption. Other things equal, when the price goes up, demand goes down. And when the price goes down, demand goes up. Or other things equal or other things remaining the same. Demand, we say other things equal, or we can also say other things remaining the same. Other things remaining the same. When the price goes up, demand goes down. When the price goes down, demand goes up. What are the things which will remain the same? Technology will be same. Why? Because if technology changes, price goes up, demand goes up, our law becomes wrong. We cannot say our law is wrong. That's why we make an assumption that it will be same. Fashion. If the fashion is new, price is up, demand is up. Again, the law becomes wrong. We cannot say our law is wrong, so we say that will also be same. Technology, fashion, population. If the population of a country is up, everything is expensive. Example, India. But demand is there because people have to live, they will buy. So price is up, demand is up. Again, the law becomes wrong. That's why we say population will also remain the same. So these are seasonal product. When the season is there, mango season or any of the season, that time they're very expensive. Demand is up. Again, the law becomes wrong. We cannot say the law is wrong. So again, we make an assumption that it will remain the same. That's why we make this statement, other things remaining the same. And what are the other things? Fashion, technology, population, seasonal goods, all these, income level, all this is same. Only then our price is up, demand is down, price is down, demand is up. Is it clear? Yeah? So when you're writing the law of demand, you have to write it in such a way that other things remaining the same. And what are the other things? fashion, technology, population, all these factors. When the price goes up, demand goes down. When the price goes down, demand goes up. Is it clear? Yeah? Is it okay, everyone? After you write the law, now you have to make a graph. So when you, this is the whole law, how you have to project it in the exam. Yeah? You write down the law, and then you write down, you make a schedule and a graph. So you write price on one side, and you write QDD or quantity demanded on the other side. You cannot say when the demand is up, price is down. You always put price first and then the demand. Because only after you see the price, you demand more on it. Yeah? So that's why we have written price here and demand here. So when the price is 10 of any the product, the demand is 2. Price comes down to 8, 4, 6, 6, 4, 8, and 2, 10. When the price is going down, demand is going up. When the price is going up, demand is going down. So that is your law. So you write down the law, you draw the schedule, now you have to draw the graph. Remember, in economics, anything that we talk about money, yeah, price, income, wages, it always comes on this y-axis. And the other variable will come on the x-axis. So this demand QDD comes here and price comes here. Always money, y. Other factor, done. So when the price is 2, the demand is 10. 4, 8. Sorry for the bad drawing because I'm too bad with it. You all can make it neat one. Yeah? Now you have to make the curve. The banana. So this is the demand curve. And you write D, D. The demand curve slopes down from left to right. That's how you write down the whole law of demand. You explain the law, you draw the graph, the schedule, and the graph. And then you can just write a two-liner down that the slope is always downward from left to right. Is it clear, everyone? Okay? Newcomers, I don't know.
Just
yeah, you missed the first.
Maybe later I ask you.
Yeah, sure. It is the willingness and ability to play. We just said that before. Willingness should be there, desire should be there, and ability, that is the money. A more formal definition is quantity demand is the entire relationship between the quantity of the commodity that buyer wishes to purchase per period of time. That's true. That at each and every period of time, what would be the desire to buy? If this season, it's mango, after 3 months, it will be a strawberry or watermelon. It won't be the same. Yeah? At that time, demand for mango will go down, but the other fruit will go up. So it is the time factor. Anything that is urgent, if a medical assistant is important at this particular time, I won't think about cinema. Right? Immediate medical attention, so that demand for that product, however expensive it is, it will be up. So that is what is very important when we talk demand. Time factor plays a very important role. And the price, of course. Okay? Yeah. So that's what we did over here. They've shown you over there in the graph. Okay? Okay. Now, when we did the law of demand and we tried to understand price up, demand down, price down, demand up, there's something called exception to the law of demand. So now we are talking exception, that is outside the law of demand. So what? How would you write that? because it is not the law of demand, it is exception. The, we will write, when the price is up, the demand is also up. When the price is down, the demand is down. So this is exception to the law of demand. Now, how do we prove this concept? The first one, first point is Giffen rules. Giffen rules. This is not there in your presentation. Why am I doing it? Because I want you to know the difference between law of demand and exception to the law of demand. So when you understand this, you can make out the difference. Yeah? Okay. Giffen rules. Yeah. You don't have to worry. Just listen to me and see my this. I have the notes, like I told you, I'll be sending it now. It's there in that. You just concentrate to what I'm saying. Yeah? You can take a picture later on, just for your reference. This Giffen goods, it's a name of a person, and that person's name is Sir Robert Giffen. So this point is from his name. His name is Sir Robert Giffen, and he gave us this law. Okay? Now what he said, we are doing exception. So our all points will be stithna, outside the law. Sir Robert Giffen told us that suppose a poor man, because he cannot afford a meat or something every day, yeah, suppose he can afford to have a 10, whatever your currency is, every month for buying potatoes, yeah, I'll talk in AED, okay, so he keeps a 10 AED every month for his potatoes, because that's what he can afford, breakfast, lunch, dinner, he has his potatoes. Now, if the price goes down, of potatoes from 10 to a 4, if it was law of demand, demand would go up, yeah, but we are studying exception. A poor person's psychology is that if the price has come down from 10 to 4, yeah, why should I eat potato what I'm eating every day? So he will now buy half a kg of potato by 2. He has a balance of 8. With this 8, he will buy some other food which he cannot eat in his regular everyday meal. So price comes down, demand also comes down, because this situation, he cannot get this advantage always. This is the first point of exception of the law of demand, which was given by Robert Giffen. Is it clear? Yeah? Okay. The second is inferior good. Inferior goods. A general psychology is, that says, any question over there in that corner? No? Is it okay? Inferior goods says, it's a normal psychology. In general, we ladies have that, that if the price is down, quality is not good, demand will go down. Vice versa. If the price is up, very good quality. So it's very good, easy for salesmen to take advantage of us, because they can increase the price and make us buy, showing that that particular product is good. Okay? Third, superior goods. We have a certain category of people also that if the price is down, they don't want to buy, thinking that my prestige, my status, my position, what people will say if I buy or use something that is low price. But when the price is up, they like to associate and purchase more, because it's a way of showing off that I can buy it. So when the price is up, demand is up. When the price is down, so this is for the rich people or for the people who think in that way. Fourth, expectation about future. This is for products like gold and, you know, the people who are playing in the stock markets and stuff. For them, when the price of gold goes up, a person who's playing in these markets, when the price goes up, demand also goes up,
because they expect that it will go up more in the
future.
If the price of gold on all these products go down, demand also goes down because they want to wait. It may fall down more in the future. So, you know, people in the stock market, if the price of shares are going up, the ones who are good players, who are regularly doing it, they feel happy. Why? Because at that time they purchase more because they know in future they will get better benefit. And there are some people who panic and they start selling because they are scared, you know, that market will crash and stuff like that. So when the price is up, demand is up because they think it will go up more and they will earn more profit. When the price goes down of these products, demand also goes down because they want to wait and take advantage in the future. Do you have any question, any doubt? You know, it disturbs me when I'm talking and I'm teaching. So if you have anything, you can ask me anytime, yeah? Okay, these are the four exception to the law of demand. Now, the fifth one, which you can add from your pocket is income. Income is up, price is up, demand will be. Income is down, price is up or down, demand will be down. Fashion. When the fashion is something new in the market, price is up, demand is up. Vice versa, if something goes old, price will be down, demand will also be down. Technology, same thing, yeah? Population. If the population is more, heavy populated country, price is up, demand is up. When the price is down, up or down the prices, the demand will be down because there are lesser number of people. Okay? So these are all the exception to the law of demand. Is it clear? Sure?
Excuse me.
Yeah.
Can you go back to the income?
Income? When the income is up, price is up, demand is also up. Vice versa, when the income is down, price is up or down, demand will be down because people don't have.
The relation between income and the price.
What is the
relation between income and the price? And why you make the income price up if it's up? If the income gone up, why the price go up?
I never said that the price is going up. Mm-hmm. We are first saying that when the price in the market is up, everything we keep the price first. So if the prices in the market is up, and if your salary is high, you have no problem. It doesn't affect you. You can demand. But if your income is down and everything is expensive or cheap, whatever it is, your demand will be down because you don't have the money, right? Anything, whenever you're talking about in this chapter of demand and supply, your first factor will be price and the other variable will always be the second. So you compare everything with the price, okay? Okay, so this was exception. This is the schedule which we just made, and they have given you another one over here with other figures, but it will be the same. One is going up and one is going down. Yeah. Don't bother yourself with this complicated thingy. Just remember the way I have told you. I told you that demand is desire, willingness, and ability to pay. Right? Now you just see this. It's the same thing, but just a bit of confusion they have put in. Q, D, and N. That is quantity demanded. Okay, the DN is, N stands for number, demand, the number of demand, okay? D, which is there, stands for demand, and after the D, there is a bracket, direct. So it means function of demand. The meaning of D and the bracket is function of demand. And inside the bracket, they have given us everything. They have given you income, they have given you the societal factor. Societal factor means, you know, either, like for example, cigarette for an underage person. Society will not accept it. So if he's going to smoke, he will not do it openly. If he has to purchase, he cannot purchase it openly, right? So you have to even consider what is allowed, what is not allowed, society, what accepts, doesn't accept. That's why they've just written social factor, yeah? So they have written price of all. You also compare with other commodities. Now they have put one of the factors, other commodities. Because when I am making a demand for a product, I always see the substitute in the market and the complement. Substitute Instead of this, what else I can buy? So I will check, I will compare the price, and then I make a decision, right? And complement, if I have a car, petrol, however expensive it is, I will buy. So the complement factor and the substitute factor, both are important when you make a demand. So these are all the functions you have to keep in mind. You first see the price, because first question is how much. Then you see the substitute and the complement. You see your pocket, can you buy it or not? And of course the societal factor, is it accepted, not accepted, legally right, not right. It doesn't mean demand, so you can buy anything, right? So legal, illegal, everything have to be considered. And then of course the D, which is the function. So demand function is everything inside the bracket. Is it clear?
Yeah.
Yeah? You can just put it in simple, desire, willingness, ability. These are the determinants of demand. Determinants of demand means what are the factors that determine your demand. So that inside the bracket, no? That last slide, all this. First is the price, because the first question when you go to demand it is how much. Then you see the substitute. So you compare, yeah? Then you see the complement. So if it's a, you're buying a car, you should see that petrol is affordable, yeah? That's why demand for car in our countries is comparatively lesser. People use public transport because petrol is very expensive. But in this part of the world, it is opposite. Household income. Then you have to always see your income and you have to fix your priority. I can't go and see 10 movies in a cinema and the rest of the month sit and cry, I don't have money. So you have to fix your priority. What is very, very important? So study of the children's education, some money in the bank as a reserve, yeah, emergency. Everything has to be in place, rent of the house. There's so many things which would be your priority. And then whatever is the surplus, you can think about where to spend it, yeah? Then you have to also see the taste and preference. That's very important. So if it is a decision in a family, what everybody likes, what they don't like, when you take a decision, it's a joint decision. If it is a company, the management have to sit together to discuss and then take a final decision. So that's why taste and preference play a very important role when you want to make a demand. Future expectation, we just did it. So in case if it is gold and shares and all that, you always do the future expectation. If the price is up, maybe you'll buy more because you think that it will become more up. It's down, up. So that's another thing which you keep in mind when you want to make the demand. Sociological and demographic factor, that's very, very important. That the society, the demography means the population, the people, yeah? So as a producer, when I'm making a product, I have to understand people are educated, uneducated. It is men, women, children. It is for the youth or it is for the older people. What is the total number of population? It is a product which is purchased daily or it is a product which is purchased once a week. The price of the product, people's income if they can afford it. All these factors I will keep in mind. I will have to do a research, otherwise if I bring a product without thinking about all this and I take a decision, who's loss? It's my loss, right? So that is why sociological, demographic factor, all these important are considered when you're making a demand. Number of children, place of residence and all that. Is it clear? Yeah? Any doubt, anyone? What happens to the demand curve if there is a change in any factor? If there is anything in this whole life changes, what would happen to the demand curve? Our demand curves come like that. If this changes, it will go opposite, right? It will be an exception. So it won't be the normal demand curve. It would be from the opposite direction because it is not falling into these factors, right? So if it is a demand curve, it will always flow from left to right. If it is not falling in the demand curve, it will go opposite from the left, from the right to left. This is? Okay, so till now law of demand is fine. Determinants of law of demand is fine. Exception to the law of demand, is it fine? If there is no answer, I assume it as yes.
Yes.
Understood?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay. So now we have to understand the shift of demand curve. There are two types of shifts. Now, they will show it to you over here. You tell me, what does it mean? What does this picture look like? It's shifting. What is happening in this curve?
At the same price, but what's the demand in the
quantity? Who was saying the same price?
At a certain price, I mean, if you fix a price, you can draw a line on the y-axis, okay? If you are saying that at a certain price, you'll find the quantity demand is moving from left to right.
I didn't understand what
the quantity is changing.
The quantity is changing.
But the price is remaining the same.
Yeah. How do you say that the price, the quantity is?
It is changing.
The whole demand curve, the dark line is the original demand curve. Yeah? You see a complete shift to the right and a complete shift to the left.
So the price went down and the quantity went
up. Okay. In this, what you see? In this case, the supply curve is changing, is one curve, sorry, yeah? Only when the price is changing, on the same supply curve, there are different points. So when the price is 100, your demand is 4. When the price is coming down to 40, so in this case, only factor is price. But in the other case, the whole demand curve is shifting. So the other factors are over here. So in the first diagram, when it's only because of the price, sometimes the demand goes up or sometimes the demand goes down. But in this case, other factors like income, technology, fashion, population, all these other factors, the whole demand curve is shifting. Sometimes it is increasing, sometimes it is decreasing. So lower the income, just one second, yeah? So lower the income, demand will decrease. So the whole curve is shifting, yeah? More the income, so the whole curve is shifting to the other side and a new demand curve. You can purchase more, okay? But in the first diagram, what do we see over there? Along the same curve only, the price and the quantity of demand is moving. This is the shift. There are two. One is only because of price. The other one is the other factors. Ask me.
No, I was telling you that if you go to the other curve, let's say a commodity, okay?
Yeah?
Let's say a certain commodity with a certain price. The price does not increase, okay? The price is fixed. Okay? You'll find that due to other factors like...
Because of other factors.